might say, well, they should know that. Well, there are some groups and some type ministries that you look at them and basically they're just a carbon copy of something they've seen. You know, many times you can go to a service, a concert, or whatever, and if you got 10 groups on the stage, if you really didn't know them personally, if you just came for the first time, you would assume that they're all the same. There was nothing that stood out. And what that says to me is many times, they don't have an individual vision. We have to be very careful. When God gives us a vision, he gives us our specific and unique place that we would operate in the kingdom. And at that point, that's where your uniqueness flows. And it's difficult to do that sometimes because many times when you're unique, you're going to be different and you might look like you won't be as accepted as the ones who are already doing it. So you tend to want to be accepted. When you get up to minister, you want people to get with you. But if God has given you something so unique, it may not be for that current audience. It may be for the audience to come, which may be much greater than that present audience. But you've got to know that you know that you know that he's given you.
He doesn't want us to get distracted on the way to salvation, deliverance, restoration, and healing. I can tell you a whole lot of things that could distract you. One is our own personal agenda being greater than his agenda. Now, our own personal agenda is about flesh. And I will say to you that that's what is taking place because that's where the enemy destroys us. He gets us, instead of wanting the message to be big, we want the messenger to be big. My friend Jerry Mannery told a story, and you know Jerry was with Malico Records, and Jerry told a story, and he said, you know when Jesus asked for the donkey that had never been ridden on, so he could ride into Jerusalem, and so he said, when he used the donkey got back to the barn, and so the donkey started talking to his other friend. He said, man, y'all won't believe what happened. I was riding through town,